I don't know. Yeah, I don't know that. There's something more to this. Well, yeah, there's something more to this. I mean, when she resigned, which was today, you think the story will go away. So I'm not sure if this story is going to go away. Because she resigned, so I'm not sure if it's going to go. It don't look like it's going away. Something else more to it. But yeah, as far as her cheating and whatnot, you know, them saying they got more photos. I mean, there's something more to it is, to me, they're going to put more news out about it. It's going to be more, how you when you write a story. What's going to be more to the script? I thought, hey, when she resigned, there won't be no more news stories. Like, they're going to let it go. Because she's not in office, so... Since she's not in office, they ain't really not going to do no news stories because she's not popular. She's not head of state or whatever. Okay. Something more to this. I don't know. She still got to go to court for the photos, but she sent the cease and desist letter to Dailymail about getting rid of the photos. I guess they still gotta talk to her husband, see if her husband's leaked the photos. So they might do a news broadcast about her husband. He might get on TV and speak. Then the staffer she had relations with, they might find a staffer, do an interview with the staffer. And let's just look at her talk for a second.
Democrat Katie Hill announced this past weekend that she is resigning from Congress. Reasons for that decision are both complicated and unnerving. Last week, the House Ethics Committee initiated an investigation into Congresswoman Hill because of an allegation.
I don't see her talking.
I will fight to ensure that no one else has to live through what I just experienced. Some people call this electronic assault, digital exploitation. Others call it revenge porn. As the victim of it, I call it one of the worst things that we can do to our sisters and our daughters. I am grateful for all of you who have spoken out about this in recent days.
And she's trying to spin this and make herself look more like the victim. The only thing I can say she's a victim of is her husband releasing photos. Like, a victim of us getting to see a tit or something. Like, really? That's it, a tit? The photos were very telling. The photos were very telling. So there's more to it than just the photos. You know, her part is worse than the photos. The thing she's done is worse than the naked photos he released. So, no, lady. Because you have more victims than you're trying to play a victim. Like, you have victims, but you're trying to play a victim. Like,
I have before, I will stand up for those who cannot stand up for themselves. Because there is one thing that I know for sure. I will not allow my experience to scare off other young women or girls from running for office.
And that part, like I read in the comment, you're not scaring off no young women or girls running for office. Unless they are homosexual, love open relationships. Unless they let their husband take, boyfriend take photos of them brushing another girl's hair while they high naked. Photos with bongs and whatever other photos may come out in the coming days from the husband. Whatever other material, whoever may bring out about her, like whatever S-rated material may come out about her in the coming days, about whoever, released it.
Sake of all of us, we cannot let that happen.
The rattling reality is that this appears to have experienced.
I'm going back to the beginning of that, but she did a whole 4-minute speech. I'm not going to go over. Like, you resigned, but why are you giving a speech the next day after you resigned? Like, lady, you think you would want to get out the spotlight and go off and drive off into the sunset and get away from all the noise and the news?
Hill notes in her statement is illegal.
I will fight to ensure that no one else has to live through what I just experienced.
Okay, we saw this. Okay.
Some people call this electronic assault, digital exploitation.
Whatever. Sound more like, hopefully they don't try to bring more bills that go against the Constitution, that go against freedom. Because you know you're going to have a bunch of cheating white women, a bunch of cheating housewives who only side with her. Like, let me go back. They ain't even got to be white. I just say white. They ain't got to be white. It could be black or white. Like I said, we're all humans. Colors don't matter. Colors are all illusion. Black and white are illusion, so it don't matter. Everybody cheats. Not everybody, but you know what I mean. Everybody, every human cheats. As far as it goes into this matrix of colors, every human cheats. As far as this matrix goes, every doesn't matter what color. You get what I'm saying? Let's go back to the comment. Like I said, there's something more to this. There's more to come because she shouldn't. She should have just went into the sunset, rode off. Now, that could have been a woman comment, but like a man who commented that, she should have stayed, fought, and wrote legislation. We better start getting used to seeing appropriate pic. Man, if you lived in the 90s, there was a lot of sex tapes by celebrities, this and that. This is not new. Man, they've been have laws against releasing sex tapes and photos and stuff. Now, this one was a woman who wrote this. I like Katie Hill. Her mistake was being married to a wicked man. I would still gladly vote for her. And of course, I replied, the wicked man? She was a wicked woman, too. What you mean wicked? It's both of them. Both of them. My wicked man? Nah, he wasn't that wicked. She let him take the photos. He kept the photos. And she didn't want sleeping around with woman and man. Yeah. Why would she keep girls from running for office? Unless those women are just like her. I hope they aren't using her to restrict freedom on social media. They did blame this on Trump, though, if you're listening. I'm going. Hold on, I'll go to it. And why is she not using this as a platform, you guys? How you gonna use you being a cheater, drug addict? I still ain't seen no cross. I ain't we're looking for no cross on her pelvic. Possible races, whatever else coming out about her in the coming days, if anything more, gonna be released. Like, come on, lady. People trying to say, oh, she didn't cheat with the congressman because she said she didn't. But she could be lying. Even though she said she didn't cheat, she could be lying about it. So, I mean, come on. Pretty much. I think she did sleep with him. Let me see. Another woman, was the relationship on the course of a divorce? Even if it was on the course of a divorce, which he filed, I don't see how it can be on the course of divorce, but he filed. But they were still together when she slept around. That's why he filed. Even though they had a threesome with the staffer, with the female staffer. So, then she slept with another man behind his back. So, she still would have resigned over her sleeping with the female staffer. Giving the female staffer $5K and then sleeping with another dude behind her husband's back. Then, beforehand, there was concern about her getting drunk and not showing up for plane flights, not showing up for work as a congresswoman. If she did show up, she wasn't as productive being hungover. So it's more than just the photos. Yeah, I believe, you know. The husband was petty. Yeah. It's nice to know, though. It's nice to know that the leadership is up to no good. So, petty, but she was up to no good. And I don't understand what he said. Why didn't reply? Oh, Greg, double standard. I don't understand. That's it for right now. But yeah, people trying to say, spin this, make her look good. And trying to blame the husband 100%. All he did was release photos. And she did everything else to herself. So she's a victim of her own victimization. A victim of her own victimization. That was funny. Both her husbands looked too trashy for this kid. How you supposed to look? I mean, all them old people. Yeah, Joe Biden looking old. Old and trashy. Mike Pence with his gray golden hair. Look like Mike Pence dyed his hair gray. He put extra gray in there. He look old. And trashy for this gig. Of course, Donald Trump is old and trashy. Hope that's a joke. I see no problem. Yeah, what's the big deal? Yeah, that must be a girl who said, "What's the big deal?" And one more time, whatever.
Others call it.
Days ago, and I think there's, I mean, we should say for apples to apples, Joe Barton, who's a Republican Texas congressman, did have images, intimate images, him posted and published. He did not resign, but he announced he was retiring.
I just want to see her talk like she's speaking for Me Too movement or something.
So that'd be some permanent, like, source of blackmail that every person that has a grudge out for you for the rest of your life, yeah, that you dated in college and then you
called the monkey business, yes, not even doing monkey business, to, you know, Bill Clinton with sort of phone calls before he became the president, right, with
yeah, this is what they're talking about, them spinning it, talking about the guys, do the same thing. It's not about the guys this time, it's about Katie Hill. Okay, we on Katie Hill, we're not on old ass Bill Clinton. I think she mentioned Newt Gingrich or somebody cheating on their wife or whoever, or they old ass.
That we should be addressing.
You can also report on it without posting the images, which seems to me like part of what's happening. The other thing that someone on, well, you are essentially complicit, mm-hmm, in a crime, in a statutory violation.
But not just complicit in, you are making it now a story, and it's a titillating story. It's a story.
That's the other thing you can't get around, exactly.
Right? And this is something that it's not appropriate, has nothing to do with the other part that we should be addressing.
You can also report on it without posting the
with how this all
and
sort
I
of shook out.
Matt Gaetz, who's obviously a very conservative member of Congress and very polarizing and polemical figure, defended her a few days ago. And I think there's, I mean, we should say for apples to apples, Joe Barton is a Republican in Texas.
The only thing about this you can defend is the husband being wrong for releasing the photos. But nothing else was wrong. Like, the rest you really can't defend. Nothing else she did.
Congressman did have images, intimate images, him posted and published. He did not resign, but he announced he was retiring. So that is a thing that has happened recently, which, again, I felt at the time that it was messed up for people to publish that.
Right.
Like,
right.
We should say Red State and Daily Mail, I think, are the two outlets that published this. And, like, that decision to me is just utterly and completely indefensible. You are essentially complicit, mm-hmm, in a crime, in a statutory violation.
But not just complicit in, you are making it now a story. And it's a titillating story. It's a story.
That's the other thing you can't
story
get around. Exactly.
Right? And this is something that it's not appropriate. It has nothing to do with the other part that we should be addressing.
Again, they already have laws against people posting photos and whatnot. So what law can they make? And what laws are they going to make? And they try to make any legislation. It's just going to be more scratching away at the Constitution. They already have laws that say simply don't post your girlfriend, boyfriend photo without their consent. Simply. Don't post new photos without consent.
You can also report on it without posting
this out. We have men who are currently in her own state who are waiting. Just, you know, we'll see if it passes over. They didn't resign. I'm thinking of Duncan Hunter.
Duncan Hunter.
I'm thinking of...
Well, they didn't resign because they chose not to. I was surprised she resigned. But she's still on TV giving speeches, so.
Roy Gingrich, who had multiple affairs on his first wife and multiple affairs with his second wife, both with staffers and campaign aides, right? And so these are ways that men in so many ways.
Why is she talking about men? We're talking about Katie Hill being adulterous, drug user, drunk, missing work, missing planes, homosexual, just not fit for the job. She's talking about men.
Get a pass.
That's what I mean by the Me Too. Like she sound like she's from Me Too.
By the press.
She changed the whole subject over to other guys, what the guys doing. We changed the whole topic and subject, really. Because you're not talking about Katie no more. You're talking about guys now.
Get a pass by their colleague. Another example of...
I can't nobody talk about Joe Biden no more, huh? Joe Biden and what he do around kids and whatnot. What Joe Biden be rubbing shoulders and making people feel uncomfortable. Mr. Biden.
And time and time again, able to ride this out. We have men who are currently in her own state who are waiting. Certain journalists.
Okay, I'm going back.
Yeah, journals.
I mean, if you can call it.
Journalists.
That,
yeah. Yeah, exactly. Who published these photos? I mean, this is a form of technological domestic violence in some ways.
Yeah.
Especially if the soon to be a
technological domestic. Shut up. It's called embarrassing your spouse, trying to embarrass the other person, trying to one up. He must be real hurt if he posts her photos like. The husband must be real hurt or something to post the photos or to sell the photos. Cause she must have did something to make him mad, real mad. Like really. That man, he straight up don't like her. That's why he sold the photos to Dailymail. He straight up don't like his ex-wife. Right. So to me, that's something. If I'm reading into it right, that's something she did to piss him off, besides her cheating. Well, that person that said she didn't cheat, because she denied it, so she could be lying. I'm going to new, then we're going to end this video. Oh, yeah. She bruised my stomach with that nose shit. I don't know who knows he talking about. Resign. Yeah, you can't. Oh, you can't start a platform when you resign. What the platform gonna be? Like everywhere you go, they're like, oh, they go that cheating girl, cheating whatever, right there. That cheating homosexual, brushing somebody's hair. Butt naked. And I agree with that. Three other people did. Well, not really. Well, that's probation at the most. Slap on the wrist in his case. Slap on the wrist because he doesn't have a record. So slap on the wrist. We're posting the photos. Come on, naked photos. Come on. And she's 32 years old. Come on. Let me hope and find this so I can end this video. How Trump get into this? I don't know why people bring Trump into this. Trump can't sleep with her. I think it was under... Well, y'all see the comments. Y'all see the comments. There's a consensual for she's a single young woman. How is the problem we have president? No, she wasn't single when she slept with the female staffer and her husband. And she wasn't single when she slept with that other dude that was accusing her of sleeping with. So I don't get that comment. She's a lovely single woman. I don't get that comment. personal business. Anyway. And dude, I don't know who he's talking to, but let's read this. Because earlier I said I didn't get what John was saying, but they understand what John's saying. Dude, they were already separated. She was technically single. No, she wasn't. Well, he just filed for divorce when? In July. And he the one who took the photos, right? So I'm pretty sure before July, while she was hanging out, go back to my other videos, hanging out, drinking, she was sleeping with that other dude. So this is people trying to, let me write him back. Okay, I'm gonna end this video right there. This has been Awkward Occurrence with Awkward Entertainment, and we will see you in the next video. Summer, when it comes to the weekend, play some cards, break my hair, creep with me on weekends. She can't take me on a weekday, cause her man is tweaking. Now she got many.